Ladies and gentlemen, it's your boy Jiaoyun429 bringing you part 18 of my Let's Play of God of War. No, play 17, yeah. I think it's 18. Yeah, I gotta adjust my thing. Sorry, folks. Yeah. Anyway, back to what I was saying. Part 18 of my Let's Play God of War 2018. Dragon Terrace and. Yeah, Dragon and Terror. Sorry, I'm a little bit spaced out, folks. I just had a big lunch. Anyway, last chapter we took on Sigrun in a long, epic fight, but we won, and we started doing a bit of the Dragon's Quest for dwarves. And after that, we're also doing the Realm Tears we find.
It's kind of run down.
What did you expect?
I don't know. West Ruin, I guess? Do you hear that?
No. What do you hear, boy?
Crying. They're getting louder. They sound almost like... Hello!
Okay. Let's go follow it. Let's see what's behind our throne.
A secret passage.
Well, wouldn't be a proper throne room without a secret passage.
Cool day calls for a homemade chili.
From him. Those must be the three mythical ingredients Brock was talking about.
I can say with utmost certainty that I've never laid eye on a stranger set of objects in my life.
How are Brock and Sindri supposed to build with whatever they are?
Don't count the dwarves out, lad. They're right pricks, but they're resourceful.
Thank you.
They once made an unbreakable chain out of little more than a cat's footstep and bird spit.
That doesn't even make sense.
Well, that's the legend. If you wanted sense, you shouldn't be talking to a severed head.
Okay, good point there, Mimir.
Another one here.
Starcatter. Wow, that's a lot of arms.
That's fair to say.
6, 7, 8? Could he shoot 4 bows at once?
More of a swordsman. He did only have the 2 eyes.
Looks like Thor cut him down to size.
It's what he does.
I don't need to worry about speed. Nice. Yep, I went one big circle. Sorry, folks. Mm-hmm. I'm not getting lost. Yep, I am. Trying to remember how to get the hell out of here, folks. Sorry. I know I'm going in circles. Now I'll get my bearings back. And there we go. That's where I got confused at. Stupid bridge there.
Look right beaming. Well, just work.
They found the materials. But they're so weird. How do you build a piece of armor out of something so...
Nanya.
Nanya?
Nanya fucking business. Trade secret. We get our ways.
Oh.
Been putzing around Niflheim, have we?
How can you tell?
I'd recognize Evaldi's stench of failure anywhere. Plus, you still got some mist on your shoes. What's it gonna be this? You take care now.
No, that's tight. East of Midgar. Go opening the gate from Stone Falls. Now, nowhere to go.
Why you ever wanted to work for Odin?
Back then, I was young enough to still be ambitious. The Aesir gods were as powerful a force as I've come across, but they clearly lacked for strategy, focus, and sage counsel. This could I faithfully provide. And so, a stranger from a far-off island found himself with Odin's ear, trusted as he trusted no one but himself. And with that kind of power, laddie, I must confess, there are perks.
Yeah, but he's Odin.
I never claim to be perfect, laddie. Only clever. And often too clever by half.
So what'd you do to get Odin so mad at you?
Well, for a long time my job was to enable Odin, and I was fucking excellent at it. Gradually, as I grew more to care about people and the world, my job became to contain him, to protect him from himself. By serving peace, I served his interests as well. That's the truth. But he saw it as disloyalty. No longer trusting my motives, but not wishing to part with my brain or tongue, he bound me to a tree, and adopted a new pastime of casual torture.
Well, I'm glad we came along to cut off your head.
Aye, lad. Lucky break that was.
Come on, sing it, folks. Sorry about that, folks.
Another name. Air. That's all the ones I see. How are we supposed to light the braziers on a tower that's not there?
I think we have to reopen the passage. That's a good question there, Atreus. Between the realms. Okay. First things first. We're going to go to stone walls. There are three more tiers. I think one of them is behind Odin's door. Sorry, folks.
Lemir, why don't you tell us the story of the giant that stole Thor's hammer?
Happily, my boy. It involves your friend Freya, too, though I don't expect it's one she'd enjoy being reminded of. The giant was called Grim, and he proved cunning enough to make off with Mjolnir while the Thunderlummox slept. Sadly for Thrym, he didn't always think with his brain. Though he had robbed the greatest giant killer of his greatest weapon, he offered to trade it back to the Aesir in exchange for Freya as his bride. Now, at this point, Freya was married to Odin, and Odin, frankly, would have traded her for a sufficiently strong mead, but he saw an opportunity here. Thrym's palace was in Jotunheim, and only giants know the way. By agreeing to the marriage, they'd have to escort Freya back to their realm. So, Odin coerced Freya into using her Saether magics to conceal Thor, so he could sneak along with her and infiltrate Jotunheim. When the hammer was produced as the wedding dowry, Thor revealed himself. He took back Mjolnir and wasted no time in smashing Thrym's skull, followed by every other giant present for the festivities. The only thing that put a stop to it was Freya, who wanted no part of this massacre. She cast a powerful spell that hurtled them both out of Jotunheim with no means of return. Odin was livid, hoping that Thor's foothold in Jotunheim would become his own. And oh, would he ever revenge himself upon Freya?
What is the point of this story, Head?
Well, for Thrym, the lesson would be to keep his priorities straight. For Freya, it's that doing good has a price. For Thor, it's that no object of power makes you what you are. And if what you are is the biggest butchering bastard in the Nine Realms, nobody can take that away from you.
Okay, I think I see how.
Ready yourself.
Say my name. Looks like I missed a Yiga to still do. I'll get it later.
I'm ready!
Come and face me, God of Thunder!
Your challenges mean nothing to the gods, Spirit. They do not listen.
Do not mock my pursuit of vengeance. Though my family devoted their lives to worshipping Thor, I've devoted mine to his downfall. And I will start with that statue over my father's grave.
Unlikely. You are dead.
Is there something we can do?
For a reward, of course.
If you bring down the statue, you have my blessing to loot my father's grave. He rests on an island.
Why do you hate Thor so much?
After my father passed, my mother built the statue to watch over his grave. Imagine our surprise when the God of Thunder himself came off of gold. My mother begged him to leave.
Labors, huh?
My father's grave lies on an island to the east. Do not mistake my mother's statue of Thor with that monstrous eyes.
Thanks, Atreus.
That spirit.
The one whose mom was killed by Thor? What about him?
Will his story be a reminder? The lives of men mean nothing to the gods.
I know, Father.
You know. But do you listen?
Yes.
Good.
Might seem that he's probably having a may do if I die because of a god, don't avenge me. It ain't gonna be worth it because that's how he died.
Okay. What about the giant with eight arms?
Starkath the Mighty, he was called. If the giants ever had anything so organized as an army, Starkath would have been their general. An opinion in retrospect, I should have kept to myself. But no, as Odin's advisor, I kept him advised. And having bent his will towards Starkath's doom, there was no dissuading him. But even Thor wasn't stupid enough to take on Starkath on his own. No. Instead, the Aesir set forth slanders upon Starkath's name, branding him throughout the realms as a monster to be feared. They said he abducted an elf queen who killed herself rather than be ravished by the giant. Lies, of course, but you're too young for her story. In the end, even the Vanir gods and the armies of Midgard were roused to the cause. They surrounded Starkath, showered him with arrows until he was brought to his knees. Surrendered, hoping by trial he could clear his name. Thor took advantage and ripped off one of Starkath's arms, which only made it easier to sever another and another until he was satisfied. Relieved of six arms and too much blood, Starkath perished upon the battlefield. Ah, I regret it to this day, you know. I told myself there was nothing I could do, but I wish I'd tried.
See ya.
I thought we were gone.
Boy, you underestimate your father.
Of the Dwarven King. Dwarven King? Have you ever heard of a Dwarven King?
No.
I'd heard rumors of a powerful dwarf ruling over some poor sods not far from here. Not that you asked me.
Sure, I'm open.
Guess that worked out.
Be ready.
Why did you do that, Kratos? Yeah, big Lennox.
What happened to these people?
Follow the clues.
Okay. Well, scorch marks. They're all grouped together. So maybe they were hiding from some kind of fire breather. But they died anyways. Dwarf King. King of mankind. Sounds like he wasn't a very good king. I wonder why they hated him so much.
They are dead now. Does it matter?
Nah. I'm just curious.
Curiosity is dangerous, boy. Stay focused.
Old saying, curiosity kills cats.
How do you even begin to build statues this big?
Dwarves are resourceful creatures. Annoying, but resourceful.
I guess they must have been pretty important dwarves.
I knew there was one around here.
That sounds like a dragon.
To the last one.
There's a dwarf statue on that island. That must be where the spirit's father is buried.
1 second, folks. I gotta take care of something real quick. Give me 1 second to pause.
Watch out for the dummy.
I am aware of it, boy.
Actually, those are pretty good.
No longer. Mother's wish. You are too eager, boy. It may attack us, and you will be forced to kill it. We'll see.
Thank you.
Eat you!
The axe.
Be around here somewhere.
Faith in their king, even after he got so many of them killed?
It is a command to have faith despite his failures.
A great huntress.
That's right. Queen of the hunt, they called her.
That's her father. And all the animals she had.
He taught her well.
Her father. Both of them.
They're still there. That's the story.
Thank you.
morph filtered? This is an aggressive weapon.
Behind you, brother!
The Dwarf King made his subjects hunt dragons and other monsters for him?
Enemies ahead!
To see this. Looks like that lever over there is free.
You will attack.
I know, but it feels wrong to keep them in cages like this.
Your emotions again, boy.
You can't hear their thoughts. I can't.
Ignore them and ready yourself.
Okay.
You're their honor. Thinking now?
Well, nothing. But he was grateful to die in battle. instead of rotting in a cage.
Your skill is improving. You fought well, Atreus.
Thank you, Father.
Well, let's check it out this way, see where it goes.
Feels good. Yes, sir. Please don't eat us. Please don't eat us.
Boy, prepare yourself.
Does the dragons. Oh, four more are missing. Okay. I know there's one here, so I'm gonna have to find it.
Follow me, Atreus.
Hmm. I think I'm going in circles.
All the people who lived here.
Follow the clues, boy.
Right. Follow the clues. Okay, so there was an evil dwarf king, and he made all these people hunt monsters. The people put them in cages, and then I don't know.
We are missing a clue.
Back inside the castle?
No. There is nothing more for us inside. But stay alert for chain dragons, boy. Perhaps you'll uncover more about this dwarf king.
Two more left here. And then one more left if I'm right. Elf hunt.
Here it is. It's gotta have a weak one. Somewhere. Take that!
Throw you off.
His father's great. Find anything good?
Perhaps.
Father, why don't you bring down that statue, right?
There he goes!
planning on doing this himself.
Easily, boy.
I know. I was just joking.
Nor are they a joking matter.
Sorry. Father, why do the gods cause so much trouble for mortals?
Because that is their nature.
But with all that power, you would think at least some of them would try to make life better for people.
And yet, the gods continue to spread misery. This is life, boy.
Well, at least we're doing some good, right?
Are we, Atreus? I want to believe we are, but
Lemire,
I don't know.
Is there a story for the giant with the flaming sword?
Shoot the brain. Of course. We've spoken so much of frost giants. It's about time we instead met the most fiery giant of all. Back when Ymir first emerged from Ginnungagap, it was Surt who followed next. He came from Muspelheim, the Fire Realm, bringing heat to the young cosmos, conjuring the sun from his primordial flame. But let's come back to that flaming sword, shall we? Surt the Brave forged his sword of flame for one purpose alone, to burn down Asgard when Ragnarok comes at last. His destiny is to fall at the hands of Thor and Odin, but in so doing, strike the blow that leaves their realm in ash and ruin. And from that destruction, the world can be born anew. Until then, alone he waits in Muspelheim, never sleeping, ever honing his fiery blade. Brave, generous suit, who knows he lives but to his doom. All because he chooses to serve a grand cycle so much bigger than himself. To truly embrace your purpose and the patience and sacrifice it demands is to ensure your day will come.
You think we'll be there when that day comes?
I've seen enough of war between the gods, but you, little brother, you can say.
Hey, Bra, you ever hear of a Dwarf King?
I suppose you're talking about Mosignir? Some bitch ruled over the humans once lived in this area. Built itself a castle just north of you.
A dwarven castle? What's it like?
You got yourself a pair of eyes and legs, ain't you? Might want to stock up before you head that way, though. Old Mosignir's known for collecting all manner of killering creatures. Not sure who's looking after him now. What's it gonna be this time?
Huh?
see you sweating the details. See you next, whereas I see you.
Tell me about that giant lady with the bow.
She was called Skadi, Queen of the Hunt. Her father was Thjotsi, who could take the shape of any wild creature, and taught Skadi how to hunt them all.
Know what?
I'll tell this one later.
Thank you.
go.
You there? The statue stands no longer, spirit.
Then my bond to this realm is severed. And I am off to find the real God of Thunder. He will know retribution. My deepest gratitude.
Off he goes. Brave God. Want to look for Thor on his own.
He's a fool.
I'm gonna take a look at there.
Follow me, Atreus. Hmm.
Let's do it. Just wanted to stare into my eye.
Check out that out. I don't got anything here.
So, if you remember, I started a doozy of a story early. It's about Skadi, the queen of the hunt. From the ribs of pack beasts, she fashioned second feet, allowing her to glide upon the snow so no animal could evade her. She became a huntress beyond compare, even to any god. Odin himself wanted her for his bride, believing she would bear him strong sons. But she spurned his affections, and for that insult, Odin vowed revenge. It was put forth that the Aesir were plagued by an eagle who would steal the precious golden apples of Idun.
One second, folks.
Even the finest archer among the gods could bring it down. Odin knew that Skadi could not resist the temptation to prove herself superior, and so she joined the hunt. Skadi tracked the eagle as it flew where she alone could glide, and loosed an arrow from her unerring bow. When she collected her quarry, she found no eagle at all. But her own father, poor Thiotzi, slain by his own daughter. She was overcome with grief and shame, for there is nothing nature so reviles as a child who kills their parent. Skadi succumbed to her fate as winter's blanket fell, holding her father as the mountain held her in an embrace to last eternity.
Well, that was sad.
The what? Tell us one later.
Here we go!
Kill me!
Nice to have an easy fight every once in a while.
There's some loot up there. I see something down there. Come here. Can you finish that story you started?
We were near the end of Skadi's tale, as the Queen of the Hunt discovered that Odin had tricked her own father. And we'll pick this up later.
Folks, give me a few minutes. I should be back within 20-30 minutes. I'm gonna keep going till like I want to say 1:30, 2 o'clock, but we'll see. I'm gonna give at least one more hour to find the last of the two realm tiers. One already knows in Alpine, the other one's somewhere inside Midgard. Once I get them, I'm gonna call it a night for that story. Until tomorrow, we'll resume the last of the game. And by all rights, George, I think that's it. Until then, I'll be back in about 15 minutes. back in boat. Okay, I'm gonna check the boat.
Come here. Can you finish that story you started?
We were near the end of Skadi's tale, as the Queen of the Hunt discovered that Odin had tricked her into slaying her own father. Aye, there aren't many happy endings for the giants, I'm afraid.
Thanks, Spaniels. I'm gonna check right now. Must be missing something. I didn't do that much on the boat. Okay, not up here. So supposedly somewhere on the boat. We'll check the Cliffs of the Raven out next.
That dragon, that's Baldur's, isn't it?
Yes.
And you brought it down to save me?
It was very heroic.
Come on, same folks. Thank you. I think I see what they mean by boat. Finally get what they meant by boat. Maybe they saw it on Iron Hill somewhere, or they probably told me I may have forgotten, or may have forgotten it there. Okay, not there. Gotta go back to Vanaheim. I'm gonna take a look at Vanaheim Tower real quick. I think it may be in there. For some reason, I think it may be in there. Up there. If I don't find the one here, then I'm gonna find go to an Elfheim. Sorry, folks. Didn't mean to sneeze that loud. No, so I might have to fight those things again. It's not.
Oh.
One last place, folks. Alpheim. And we're going for it right now. There are only two locations it could be.
Just wanted to stare into my eyes.
Ah!
There sure is a lot to see here.
Some Radagascar. Must have summoned Radagascar by accident. Check the first one.
Thank you.
Sorry about that, folks. I'm back now. Fight the last of them all. And that's the last of the realm terrors, folks. I think that will call our stream for tonight. We're gonna make our way out of here, and then we are gonna have fun in the last portion of the quests. I know I still gotta kill all the ravens, but you know what? I'm no bird exterminator. Besides, I took enough birds' lives. So, we're gonna head back, and we're gonna go on to the quest. We're not too far from the finishing the game, so might as well finish it, then we'll get ready for God of War 2. Well, God of War Ragnarok, you know what I mean. So, we're gonna head back to Midgard. And we're gonna get ready to call it a night when we get closer to Tyr's Secret Vault door, or whatever it's called.
Creative today.
Was there more? Let me think.
Atreus, to me.
I ain't taking a long run. You know what? I'll take this one because it knows we got everything done. Or Realm Tears and Dragons aside. This looks like it.
Tears rune. This is it.
We're inside. But what is this place?
Your guess is as good as mine, little brother.
Alright, folks. Now we're going to call in here for the night. Join me tomorrow for... Part 19, Tears Room. Till then, this has been your boy, JohnYoung429, telling you happy gaming, God bless, and thank you again for dealing with me for the long waits. I appreciate that, and I'm sorry for making that so long. I'll try to edit these videos on YouTube, but I'm going to be busy this week. Till then, take care, happy gaming, and God bless.